Tattoos, this is your bro David here.
Hey guys, it's me Jano.
And today we shall be creating a DIY project because my brother wanted to, so let's do it. We are going to create a
DIY speaker.
So let's do it. Okay, but what is it? What we first shall do is
the ingredients.
The ingredients are
Elmer's glue all multi-purpose
glue.
1/2 cup
measurement.
Water. A container. Your tissue roll. A brush. Paper cutter or box cutter. Pencil and paper. So the first step that you want to do is ready your table. Please, I'm gonna put this aside. Leave paper so your table will not be wrecked. There. The next step is to measure your glue and your water. So, 1/2 cup of water. As I see, pour in the container. And 1/2 glue. Basically, 1 bar. This is 130 grams, and it is 1 bottle. Use the brush to get all the glue. We're going to take it on with this somewhere and gently mix the mixture. Let this drip for the remaining glue. Here's some. Hey. Completely out. Then you stare until you get this. Please.
I do not know, man.
Get this consistency. There.
Viscosity of water and glue mixture.
And cut out your cardboard
for the phone,
for your phone,
as example given shown below by John,
the iPhone. And this is a bit larger for other phones like mine, Note 3. First step is to tear the paper in half, or extra paper in. Use the brush to cover the paper with the glue. My brother's here for support.
Moral
support. Does it want anything to do with this?
Yes.
Gently brush the glue. Which time?
Nice.
We're doing this because we want the DIY Bluetooth to last longer. So we're using the paper mache method. Cover it so it sticks to the cardboard. And get remaining paper to cover the whole thing. Just like so. Grab a piece of paper to the extra opening. Then fold the extra inside the cardboard. Then wet your hands to put the solution. Then you don't want to cover your hole because that's where you put your phone, basically. Cut it up again. Okay. So my brother suggests that we'll cut this out again. So that's what I'm gonna do. You'll get your hands dirty in the process. Spread the mixture evenly. As so. Yeah. And use some of your remaining paper. And have some more for the finishing touches. There, thank you, my brother, for giving me extra paper. Very supportive, brother. Oh. Covering up the whole paper roll with this mixture. Thank you. And cover up the whole paper roll. And again, fold the remaining, the extra paper inside for added protection. And make sure to cover up the whole roll. Add the finishing touches to the unattached pieces. And let it dry. And they're very sticky because of the glue. First layer is complete, and then you're gonna cover it up for the second layer. Just gonna wash my hands. Hello, I'm back. Just wash my hands. And let's add the second layer of paper. Look at it. If you add more layers to your speaker, you will have a more durable for this speaker because of the paper protecting it from other things. Spread the glue wisely. Second layer, covering up the whole roll. If you really want to strengthen up your paper, you can add 3 layers. But for now, in this video, I'm gonna add only 2 layers. Gently brush, don't put force or else you will tear the paper. And don't use too much glue, because the more glue you use, the more time it will take to let it dry. If you want a stiffer body, you can use more, but as a cost, it will dry longer. Cover it up. There. As you can see, we have creases. This will eventually wear out. There.
Let dry.
I'm gonna dry this for like 30 minutes and we'll be back at you in a moment. Bye bye.
Hey guys, I'm back and this is the finished product of our project. This is part 1 over 2 and this is not yet dried truly, as you can see, but in the next part we have decided to paint this with any color that we want, so stay tuned for that. And this is the first part of the DIY speaker and thanks for watching. See you guys soon.